Columbia University. Here's the number.
Columbia University, operator speaking. How may I direct your call?
How about Sam Durkin? Is there a Sam Durkin listed?
Sam Durkin, yes. Hold, please.
It's about time.
Durkin.
Is this Sam?
Yeah. Who's this?
My name is Lauren Blackwell. I was hoping to ask you a few questions about your mother.
Oh. Questions, huh?
Yeah.
All right. I'll bite. How do you know my mom?
I was her neighbor.
You used to live in that dump?
Yeah.
And you knew Mavis?
Very well.
You actually talked to her?
Yeah, all the time.
Where, in the hallway?
Why all the questions?
Because I don't believe you.
Whether you believe me or not, it can't hurt to talk to me.
Maybe. Maybe not. But if you knew her, you'd know what apartment number she was in.
I would?
Sure you would. She never left the damn place. So what was it? Alright, so maybe you did know her.
Thank you.
So what do you want to know about her?
What do you know about her death?
It was suicide.
She killed herself?
Not literally, but it was like she chose to die. She had every opportunity to leave. They were gonna pay her and find her a new place and everything. I tried to get her out, but that's my mom. She couldn't be dragged out of that dump by anybody or anything.
Do you know who killed her?
She was killed by some junkie, wasn't she?
So they say.
You think different?
That's what I'm trying to find out.
Well, good luck to you.
How close were you with your mother?
Close. Think of the farthest place you can, and add another 10,000 miles. That's how close we were. Woman wasn't a mother, just crazy on wheels.
Did Mavis ever leave her apartment?
Never. Not once in the last 15 years.
You don't seem upset by her death.
Upset? Sure, she was my mom. But am I gonna lose sleep? No. She drove my pop out of the house and into an early grave. I once thought I'd follow in his footsteps, but not anymore. The woman didn't go anywhere, never did anything. She was killing me just by existing. Now I feel like I can breathe again. That's the truth.
What was it like living with her?
You kidding? I lived with my pop. After 3 years of marriage, he had enough. Glad he had the sense to take me with him.
And after your father died?
I got by.
You never visited your mother?
Yeah, I visited her on Mother's Day, if that's what you want to know. Even got her a present once.
Really?
Yeah, for all the good it did.
What did you give your mom for Mother's Day?
I don't think that's any of your business, lady. It's been years. Just dust on the ground now.
Bye, Sam. Thanks for your time.
Yeah.
Come on, let's get out of here.
Right behind.
Yes? Twice in one evening? Come on in, sit down.
Did you know Mavis Wilcox?
Miss Wilcox? Yes, I remember her. Lived uptown a ways before she died.
How did you know her?
I wanted to write a piece about her, so I met her for a spell. Interesting woman. How did you know her?
I'm looking into her death.
I see.
So what can you tell me about Mavis? I get the impression she didn't get out much.
That's an understatement. I got in touch with her through a colleague who was covering that demolition. I wondered what made a woman like that tick, so I made an appointment to meet with her.
What was she like?
A very gracious woman. Brought me in, made me a cup of tea, showed me pictures of her family. All in all, it was a pleasant way to spend an afternoon.
What happened to her?
Killed, so they say. Was found choked to death in her own apartment.
Any thoughts on who did it?
Well, there were rumors that the labor union decided to take matters into their own hands, as it were. But I doubt that. The police ruled it was some squatter or drifter or something, and left it at that.
And what do you think?
Me? I have no theory.
Why did you want to write about her?
I found her fascinating. She was asked to leave. She was begged to leave. She was even offered lots of money to leave. But she kept refusing. She was too scared. I had to know why.
And what did you discover?
That, Miss Blackwell, is the eternal question. I've spoken to hundreds of people over the years. Most of them were odder than Mavis. It's impossible to decipher the whys and the hows. As time went on, I've contented myself just with the whats.
Anything else you can tell me about Mavis?
I'm afraid I've told you everything.
Did Mavis ever mention a gift or present from her son?
Now that you mention it, yes. She showed me a leather-bound edition of Alice in Wonderland and said it was from her son.
Alice in Wonderland?
Yes, by Lewis Carroll.
Yeah, I've heard of it. I think that's all.
All right, you have a good night.
I'm going in again. You know what to do.
Yeah, I'll wait here.
My home.
Hey, kid.
Mom.
Oh, hello, Sam.
Hi, Mom. Hey, Mom. Do you have that present I gave you?
Which present was that?
The book, Alice in Wonderland.
Of course I still have it. It was the only Mother's Day gift you ever bought me, Sam.
Can I see it?
Whatever for.
Come on, Ma. I just want to see it.
Sure, Sam. It's right on the table.
Great. Why don't you bring it out here?
You mean, pick it up?
Yeah, pick it up and bring it over.
Pick it up. Sure, I can pick it up. Oh no!
What?
The book! It's gone!
Gone, huh? Imagine that.
Somebody stole it! Sam, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
It's okay, Mom.
Okay? Okay? I lost your gift!
You can't pick up the book because it's not there.
Sam?
The book's not there, and neither is the table, right?
What?
Think! The book's gone, the table's gone, the whole room is gone.
Sam, you're awful! I'm upset and I'm sorry. Don't make it worse, please!
You need to find that book, Mom. I don't know if I can love a mother who loses my gifts.
You don't mean that.
I mean it, Mom. You need to tell me where the book is.
But I don't know where to look.
Maybe it's out here, Mom.
In the hallway?
Sure, in the hallway. Yeah, I'm sure it's out here. Come on out and help me look.
Oh, okay, Sam. But only for you. I still don't see it anywhere.
Let's try further down, Mom.
I'm outside.
Yeah, I knew you could do it, Mom.
Mom?
Sam? Sam, where are we? I'm scared.
I'm right here. Mom, I need you to do something.
What?
Turn around.
I can't.
Sure you can. Just turn around and look behind you.
Oh, where's the building? Where's my apartment? Where's my home? It's gone! Those bastards, they tore it down! You made me leave, and they tore it down!
Hey, calm down.
I've got nothing now.
Mom!
I am not your mother! You are not my son. My son hates me. All I had left was my home, and then I... Oh, God! Are you happy now? You couldn't just leave me there. You had to bring me out. You had to make me remember.
I'm sorry.
It's horrible. Being dead, it's horrible.
You get used to it.
I don't want to feel like this anymore. Everything is so dark and cold. Can I go home now?
Sure. Sure, I can take you home. Just hold on to this. Over to you, kid.
Right.
Oh my God.
Mavis?
It's so bright and big. It just goes on forever. I just want to go home. Please, can I go home?
I think that's the only home you've got now. I'm sorry.
What a legacy. Husband gone and dead. My son hates my guts. My home is gone. My life, over. I remember that too. Dying, I mean. That old woman choking me.
Old woman?
She just came in and killed me. She said she was going to help me. Well, what now?
The light, Mavis. Just head towards it.
And then?
I don't know.
I'm scared, but it feels right somehow. John, Sam, I'm so sorry for everything.
I wish I could feel sorry for you, but I don't feel much of anything anymore. Best of luck, wherever you are.
You all right?
Yeah, fine. I'm exhausted. Call it a night?
Sounds good to me.
You?
Like clockwork.
You saved her.
Yeah, sure we did. No thanks to you.
We've got some questions for you, lady.
Why did you kill Isaac and Mavis?
I didn't kill them. I'm like you.
You're nothing like us. We don't kill.
I help spirits enter the next world, like you.
You mean you're a medium?
Yes.
But you can't be.
I am like you!
Wait, no. This doesn't make any sense. Why are you killing people?
I save people! I don't hurt them!
Get back here! Stupid old hag! Let's get after her.
God damn it!
Your nose okay?
That lamppost should not have been there.